everybody. Today's class is about liver and bile. Having finished salivary gland and stomach, liver is the largest gland in the body. It is present in the right upper part of the abdominal cavity. It weighs around 1.5 kg. The liver is both exocrine and endocrine gland. Since part of its secretion directly drains into blood and remaining is drained through it, the ducts. The functional anatomy of the liver, the functions of the liver, bile composition, formation and storage of bile, types of bile, enteropathic circulation, functions of bile and bile salts, jaundice, liver functions. As you all know, the liver is the largest organ essential for life. It is reddish brown in color, friable, with two lobes enclosed in a fibrous capsule with parenchyma and connective tissue. Gallbladder is situated in the fossa or visceral surface of the right lobe. The portal vein and hepatic artery enter, and the lymphatics and two main bile ducts leave the liver at the porta. The connective tissue septa divide the liver into hepatic lobules. And this is the functional unit of liver. It weighs around 1.5 kg and which holds about 13% of total blood volume. The unit of liver cell is called as the hepatocytes. In between the layers of hepatocytes are the sinusoids. It has a unique ability to regenerate, and the average life is around 150 days. The liver lobules are semi-autonomous units. The blood input distributed among the adjacent lobules. The drainage of several lobules is mixed in the venous bed. Bile outflow is mixed in ducts at corners. Hepatocytes are arranged as plates around the central vein. You can see the spaces between the plates are called as sinusoids. Capillary spaces line the with discontinuous and fenestrated endothelium. The secretions from the hepatocytes drain through intralobular bile duct, right and left bile duct, hepatic duct, cystic duct and common bile duct, which enters the duodenum. This is the general outflow after the bile is formed in the hepatic lobule. This is the hepatic lobule arrangement. Input at the corners via the portal vein and the red color hepatic artery. Oxygenated and deoxygenated blood are mixed. The flow is towards the center and then it is out. The breakup of flow gives hepatocytes time to work. It has a large surface area and intimate contact with hepatocytes. The blood flow through the liver is, you can see the flow, how the bile flows towards the center, the functional unit of the liver. And this is a portal triad. It's made up of branch of portal vein, hepatic artery and tributary of bile duct. You can see the portal triad. It's also called as the acini. The green is the bile which flows towards the center. The unit supplied and drained. So you can see the whole thing, blue color deoxygenated blood and the bile which flows towards the portal triad. The unit supplied and drained by the portal triad. They given the direction of the flow also. The liver acini, the unit supplied and drained by terminal branches of portal and the triad vessels. So we would be looking at the functions of the liver. It can be metabolic, synthetic, detoxification. So the liver helps in the formation and secretion of bile. The bile is continuously produced in the liver cells. Around 500 to 600 ml per day of bile is produced each day. It detoxifies the body of alcohol and drugs. The first pass metabolism of any oral consumption of drug takes place in the liver, which is the microsomal enzymal system. It breaks down excess amino acids, urea, which is called the deamination. It converts glucose to glycogen for storage, which acts as a source of quick energy. It converts excess carbohydrates and fat. It stores vitamins like A, D, E, K, and stores minerals like iron, copper, and zinc. It forms plasma proteins, finally the fibrinogen, which helps in blood clotting. Albumin is also formed in the liver. It forms cholesterol needed to form many hormones. It produces heat to warm the blood. It clears blood of particles including bacteria. So it synthesizes albumin. It fights infections in the form of immunity. The Kupffer cells present in the liver are protective in function. It produces hormones including sex hormones. So this is how you generally classify them. It can be synthetic, immunity functions, the metabolic functions, the detoxification, hormone inactivation, storage in the form of glycogen and vitamin A. Finally, it forms the bile secretion. Bile is secreted by hepatic cells into the biliary capillary and is called hepatic bile. Then it is collected by hepatic ducts, which joins the cystic duct to form common bile duct. It is stored and concentrated in the gallbladder via the cystic duct. The gallbladder bile is released into the duodenum. This is how the concentration of bile takes place in the gallbladder. So you can see the right and left hepatic duct joins to form common hepatic duct, which joins with the cystic duct from the gallbladder to form the common bile duct, which along with the pancreatic duct opens into the hepatopancreatic ampulla, which is guarded by sphincter of Oddi into the duodenum. This is the biliary tree. So you can see the differences between the hepatic and gallbladder bile. The pH is lesser. The water content is more in the liver bile. The bile salts and bile pigments are more in the gallbladder bile because of the concentration. So the sodium potassium are almost similar. And the bicarbonate is more in the liver bile, chloride and bicarbonate. So the bile salts are the cholic and the chenodeoxycholic acid. These are called the primary bile acids. And the secondary bile acids, the deoxycholic and lithocholic acids, they conjugate with taurine and glycine, forming taurocholic and glycocholic acid. And sodium potassium salts of these bile salts are called the bile acids are called bile salts, which is around 10 to 20 milliequivalents per liter with a pH of 7.8 to 8.6. The lifespan of the half-life is three days. About 94% of bile salts secreted are reabsorbed in the small intestine. They enter the portal circulation and they pass back to the liver. These salts are taken up totally by the liver into the hepatic cells and then secreted into the bile. Small quantities of bile salts are lost in feces. Other substances passing through enterohepatic, entero means duodenum, from the intestine to the hepatic circulation, including thyroxine, vitamin B12, vitamin D. It flows around 6 times a day, 2 times for each meal. Only bile acids of all the steroids and lipids in the bile undergo an enterohepatic circulation. Enterohepatic circulation uses a large mass of previously synthesized bile acids. This passes through hepatocytes to generate a bile flow. These bile acids are now again available to facilitate digestion. Only 5 to 10% you can see from how enterohepatic circulation. The bile salts flow from the duodenum into the hepatic via the portal vein. Only 5 to 10% of the bile entering small intestine gets excreted in feces. 90 to 95% is reabsorbed by active process in the terminal ileum. Then it passes through the portal vein into the liver. In the liver, it is re-excreted into the bile canal alkali. Small amount loss in feces is made up by synthesis. The functions of bile can be digestive, absorptive, excretion, laxative, cholerectic, and maintaining the pH. So, fat digestion and fat absorption. The bile helps in digestion and emulsification of fat by the following actions. It reduces the surface tension. Fats are converted to emulsion, a stable solution. It activates the lipase. Bile salts act as specific activator for different lipases. It has a solvent action. Bile salts act as solvent. It also activates the pancreatic lipase and increases the release of enterokinase. The bile salts act as sporotic, that is, it acts as own stimulant for further secretion. This is brought about by bile salts present in the bile. It neutralizes the acid chyme which is released from the stomach. It acts as a vehicle for the excretion of numerous substances. It acts as a mild laxative. It permits, stimulates peristalsis and acts as a laxative. Bile is necessary for absorption by hydrotropic action. Insoluble fatty acids and cholesterol are made readily soluble in watery contents of the intestinal canal. The bile helps in maintenance of suitable pH of duodenum. The regulation of bile secretion is it's increased by vagal secretion, cholestokinin and secretin. The vagal stimulation increases bile secretion by contraction of gallbladder and relaxation of the sphincter of OD, which is present in the duodenum. It has a humoral regulation wherein the gastrointestinal hormones like secretin, CCK-PZ increases the bile secretion. Bile salts and bile acids which increase bile biliary secretion is called as chloretics, and the fatty acid which helps in contraction or increase the contraction of gallbladder is called as chlorogogs. So what is jaundice? So the simple way is, when the food enters the stomach, the sphincter of OD relaxes. The fatty acid and amino acids in the duodenum cause release of CCK. CCK is cholecystokinin pancreazymin. It causes the gallbladder contraction. Stimulation of vagus and hormone increases water and bicarbonate and thereby the content of bile acids. So jaundice is yellowish discoloration of skin, eyes and other body tissues caused by excess accumulation of bilirubin in blood. The normal serum bilirubin is 0.2 to 0.8 milligram. It is seen when it exceeds 2 milligram percent. So you know how the formation of bilirubin. Bilirubin is formed by the RBC. RBC destruction is either the free or the unconjugated form. It is bound to albumin and hence it is excreted. Uptake in the liver. It is conjugated in the liver. In the liver, the unconjugated bilirubin is split from albumin and enters the hepatocytes. It is conjugated into uridine diphosphoglucuronic acid in the presence of glucuronolytic transferase to form bilirubin mono and diglucuronides. So after the reticuloendothelium destroys the RBC, the bilirubin is the unconjugated bond form which is bound to albumin. The conjugation takes place in the liver. When it enters the hepatocytes, the bilirubin is split from the albumin. In the presence of glucuronolytic transferase, it forms mono and diglucuronides, which is water soluble. So conjugated is water soluble. It is excreted. The conjugated bilirubin is excreted by an active process against a concentration gradient into the biliary canal alkali. Some of it escapes into the circulation and is excreted by urine. The conjugated bilirubin reaches the large intestine and is degraded by the colonic bacteria, forming colorless compound called turcobilinogen. The re-excretion which happens is either the urobilinogen and standing becomes urobilin and turcobilinogen becomes turcobilin. What are the types of jaundice? It can be either prehepatic. This is caused by due to excessive breakdown of RBC. So it's called hemolysis. Excessive breakdown. The liver cannot conjugate bilirubin and therefore concentration of unconjugated bilirubin is increased in the blood. Increased serum unconjugated bilirubin, it results in anemia, reticulocytosis and abnormal RBCs. The serum albumin ratio is normal and this doesn't have any color, so it is acoloric and dark colored stools with the lefty being normal. If the damage is there to liver due to alcohol or any disease like cirrhosis or NASH, non-alcoholic steatohepatitis due to fatty liver, the fatty liver progressed to non-alcoholic. This is caused due to the hepatic jaundice, is caused due to infection and toxic damage to the liver. There is increase in both unconjugated and conjugated bilirubin in the blood. The increase in serum conjugated and unconjugated bilirubin, it can be infective, it's a normal blood feature. The AG ratio, the albumin decreases, the globulin increases, so the AG ratio is altered. Bilirubinuria, there is presence of bilirubin. There is steatorrhea, bulky stools, that is steatorrhea, LFT is impaired. The post-hepatic or the obstructive to the bile ducts, the common bile ducts, here the blood picture is normal. Most of the time the obstruction of the bile ducts is either by tumors or by stones, the gallstones. In this condition, conjugated bilirubin increases in the blood. The albumin may be low, the AG ratio is normal. There is clear-colored feces, steatorrhea, bulky stools, and this is called steatorrhea. LFT is normal or mildly impaired. There can be disorders of biliary tract and gallbladder. It can be either biliary obstruction due to stones or inflammation of the gallbladder called as cholecystitis or due to stones, the cholelithiasis, which can be either two types of stones, the cholesterol, the pigment stones. Normally cholelithiasis is a condition where stones are formed in gallbladder. These stones are calcium bilirubinate stones or cholesterol. This happens with fat fertile female of 40 years, cholelithiasis. Biliary dyskinesia can happen and external biliary. These are the stones which can be either calcium bilirubinate or cholesterol stones. So any patient, we always try to do liver function test if there's any abnormality, and the jaundice, or the fit, if you want fitness for surgery. So it can be either tests of bilirubin metabolism, wherein serum bilirubin, urinary bilirubin and urinary bilirubinogen has done. Test for protein synthesis of serum protein, the prothrombin time. If there is a damage to the liver, which can be hepatocellular, serum glutamate oxidotransferase and pyruvate transferase is done, along with alkaline phosphatase, gamma glutamyl transferase indicates the parenchymal damage or bromosulfathone clearance.